We still rocking with dog. Yeah. We still rocking with dog. We still.
Good day, everyone, and I hope you are staying safe. First time at a drive-in event? Well, here are some tips for you. Step number one, space is limited. First come, first serve. Once spaces are filled, that is it. Step number two, please stay in your vehicles, no exceptions. Your safety is so important to us. Step number three, pack your snacks. There will be no vendors on site, so please pack accordingly. No noise, please. Let's save our horns or excessive noises for after speeches. Let us give our speakers the utmost respect and not serve as a distraction for them. If you must use the restroom, please flash your lights once. An usher will come and escort you to and from the facilities. Now that you have your tips, relax and have a great time. But don't forget, it's about your future. Ready to get started? In 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Grand Bahama, Grand Bahama! Grand Bahama, are you ready, Grand Bahama?
We still rocking with dog.
Do you guys feel the victory, Grand Bahama?
We still rocking with dog.
Good night, everybody. My name is Kendall Culmer, and I will be your master of ceremonies tonight. And Grand Bahama, let me hear you make some noise again. First, we're going, as you know, we do here in FNM country, anything we do first, we must start off with a word of prayer. We must give our praise and worship the Almighty God above. So coming to the stage is Monique Boodle Burrows, the daughter of the next MP for Pine Ridge, coming to open us up with a word of prayer.
Let us pray. Most gracious and heavenly Father, I thank you for allowing us to gather here tonight. Father God, I just want to glorify and praise your name, for you are great and you are mighty, and there is none like you. God, I bring this beautiful country, our great Bahama land, before you in prayer, and the island of Grand Bahama. God, we have been a people that love you and cry unto you for your mercy and grace. You have kept us. We have endured crisis after crisis and tragedy after tragedy, yet you still allow us to stand strong, and we thank you for fighting each and every battle for us. For your word declares that you are a strong tower, and we, the righteous, run into it, and we are safe. Father, we can't thank you enough. I bring everyone who is suffering from COVID-19 under your healing balm, because your word declares by your stripes they are healed. Everyone that has lost a loved one, remind them that you are near to them and that you will bind up their wounds. God, soften our hearts and heal our land. I pray a hedge of protection over this country, each constituency, each candidate, each citizen, man, woman, and child. I know that according to the word of God, the angel of the Lord will encamp around us because we reverence you. I pray over this election, God, and that you grant us peace that surpasses all human understanding. Heavenly Father, continue to guide us under the power of the Holy Spirit and keep us in our going out and our coming in. May this rally bring glory to your mighty name. May we continue to gain confidence in the FNM administration for you have raised them up for such a time as this. Bless our leader, the Right Honorable Dr. Hubert Alexander Minnis, and keep him covered under the shed blood of Jesus Christ. Cover his administration as they use wisdom to guide us through these difficult times. May we honor them. God, most importantly, may we honor you. I seal this prayer with the shed blood of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen.
FNM's FNM.
We still rocking with Doc.
That was a very powerful prayer. I don't think you left anybody out in that, Monique. I think she covered everybody. She covered FNMs from the north straight down to the south. She covered all behemoths from east to west. And every glorified person in between. FNMs! Now remember now, we're still under a pandemic. We need you guys to group in your families at your vehicle. Remember your social distancing. Remember to sanitize. And now we're about to... The next sound you will hear will be the national anthem. I would like everybody to take their hats off, hands at their side. FNMs, make some noise. FNMs, FNMs. Next on the stage will be Miss Delancey. She will be doing a tribute to one of our great FNMs that we have lost lately, Miss Sandra Moore. And we all, let's just take a moment of silence for Miss Moore and remember the family in their time of loss.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. For on Christ, the solid rock, I stand. I have lost my rock. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with profound pride that I stand before you tonight to celebrate the life and the contributions made in this world by the late Sandra Arabella Moore. My Aunt Sandra was a devoted Christian, a woman of faith, and who knew the power of prayer. She loved to sing. Oh, she loved to sing and praise her God. And can I tell you, her worship was for real. Church of the Good Shepherd, the entire Pindus Point community, you've lost a rock. Beyond her church life, my Aunt Sandra was a nationalist. She wanted nothing but the best for the people of the Bahamas. As fate would have it, she met and fell in love with a man who was as equally committed to building a better Bahamas, in the person of Maurice Moore, my Uncle Mo. It is important to note that my Aunt Sandra, like many Bahamians in the early days of Bahamianization, stood for the cause of majority rule and independence, both tied to the PLP. But when she saw that the country was headed in the wrong direction, she stood with pride on the side of my Uncle Mo, and they left those other people and that other party. She watched her husband and a few other great men charter the course for a better choice. The Free National Movement, this party, became the instrument of change she wanted to see. So with deliberate intent, she stood at the helm of the FNM Women's Association to ensure that women played an important part in the development of this party. She worked. Oh, she labored. She fried more conch fritters and chicken and fish. And she was happy to do it, staying in the background, not looking for favor or fame or credit. The FNM Women's Association of Grand Bahama, you've lost a rock. My Aunt Sandra was the matriarch of our family. Her love for family extended beyond her children and grandchildren and nieces and nephews. It extended to communities, this island, and our country. She and Uncle Mo, they enjoyed a very active political career, and theirs was a journey of many chapters. But no greater joy came when this party got the victory at the polls in 1992. The wait was over, and the Bahamian people loudly declared that this party was the right party to make it right for all. My Aunt Sandra took on the challenges of her recent illness as she took on the challenges of this life in silence, prayerfully and gracefully. She would always say, with Christ in the vessel, you could smile at the storm. Big Mo, the Moore family, the Grand Bahama community, we've lost a rock. I know one thing for sure, that as we gathered here tonight to promote the vision of the FNM, we must all be reminded that in spite of the difficult times we face, the Free National Movement remain the better choice for us and our future. If Isandra had her way and her will, man, she would have told death, give me a little bit more time. So she could have been here with us tonight, rocking with Doc and rolling in red. On behalf of Maurice and the FN and the Moore family, I wish to express our sincere thanks to the people of Grand Bahama, to the leadership, officers, and members of this great party, for all of the love, your prayers, and support. It sustained us in these difficult times, especially Uncle Mo. Sandra Arabella Moore, may she rest.
FNMs, we are here this evening because it's all about our future. Who out there is looking for a better and brighter future? Let me hear you make some noise.
He's still rocking with Doc.
This administration that will make up the next government is one that believes in Bahamians and believe in Bahamian products. So next to the stage is a young lady that is of Bahamian soil, and she will grace you in a nice song. Come on, Cheryl Rami.
Good evening, FNMs.
Ooh,
how you feel, blessed?
Tell me how.
Should be. You feel blessed. I feel blessed.
I wanna know. How can I take for granted all the things he's done for me? How can I with the same mouth praise him as the grumble and complain? I will start to be grateful. He's done for me. How can I with the same outfit?
FNMs, FNMs.
You guys are truly blessed that the leader of this party is Dr. Menes, that he was there to lead us and guide us through this pandemic. So let's all give praise and thanks for that, for us being blessed. And next to the stage is a young torchbearer by the name of Okia Saint. And before she comes on stage, folks, we must remind you to stay within your groups, stay on your vehicles, social distance, and show some FNM pride and make some noise.
Now this one to the kids and to the girl with the angel face and the devil heart. You know, so rather than check out the most new plant players come feel the kids. Step up my youth, hear this.
FNMs, make some noise! Grand Bahama, Grand Bahama. Grand Bahama, I understand how some of you feel. And I've heard the talks. I've heard some say they don't know who to vote for in this election, or this election is just a choice between the lesser of two evils. But for me, it's not a choice between the lesser of two evils. It's a choice about leadership. It's a choice between strong leadership in crises that this FNM government continues to display, or it's a choice for political promises just for the power that that other party is known for. Grand Bahama, you said you wanted a greater investment in education. This Menace administration has made education its priority. This government has launched the Universal Preschool Grant Program that covers the tuition of preschool-aged children throughout the country, making preschool accessible to thousands of Bahamian children. They didn't stop there. They also made the University of the Bahamas and BTVI free for qualifying students.
Are you serious?
As a result, UB has seen an increase in enrollment by 57%. This FNM government has clearly shown that it is invested in the future of our youth. That's leadership through crises.
We still rocking with Dogby.
We here in Grand Bahama have had some tough years. From the devastation of Hurricane Dorian to the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. But through it all, this administration has remained steadfast in its commitment to us. Through the special economic recovery zone legislation, every Grand Bahamian has benefited. If it's from exemptions to building supplies to effect the necessary repairs to our homes or businesses, from exemptions to replace our automobiles, household appliances, clothing, and groceries, this government delivered. From September 2019 to date, we are still receiving concessions. Now, many say, well, Dorian was the worst we had, and trust me, we know it was. But this government's response in the aftermath of Dorian was the best we ever had.
It's about our future.
The difficulties that we face here in Grand Bahama cannot be fixed overnight. And Grand Bahamians, if I'm to be honest with you, the journey ahead of us is not an easy one. But if this government has shown me anything in the last 4 years, it's that we are in the best hands with the FNM. $19 million has been earmarked for the phased redevelopment of Durand Memorial Hospital. You asked for it, and the FNM is delivering. The launch of My Gateway, your one-stop virtual shop for all government agencies, from e-passports to post office box rentals. You asked for digitalization, and this FNM government is delivering.
It's about our future. It's about our future.
It's renewed the 52-week job employment program. Over $44 million has been earmarked to save 15,000 Bahamian jobs. You asked for employment, and this government is delivering. Grand Bahama, the FNM has stood by you. They've stood with you, and they have stood for you. Through heartache, through pain, and as we know, through crises. So on September 16th, when you head to the polls,
If you can vote for Brave, you might as well bring Perry back.
Good evening, FNM.
Now that's some
real
bullshit.
Now this one that it gets into the gallery with the angel face and the devil heart. You know, it's a rhythm of the check and the most people don't play as the real ladies. Step up my own, you know.
I know this little girl, her name is Maxine. Her beauty's like a bunch of roses. If I ever tell you about Maxine, your own I say I don't know what I know.
FNM, next on stage is the loveliest candidate here in Grand Bahama, Miss Pakisha Parker Edgecombe.
Hello, Bahamas. I'm Pakisha Parker Edgecombe. I love my community of West Grand Bahama and Bimini. Serving its people brings me joy. I am a wife and a mother, and as a former journalist, I know the importance of tackling the issues of a society and concerns of a citizenry while working together to bring positive change. I believe that is what we are doing in West Grand Bahama and Bimini, and that is what this free national movement is about. Our constituency continues to witness infrastructure developments. Our families and the elderly of our community are being helped. Our children are being taught the importance of receiving a good education. Our economy remains steady and strengthening, with an increase in tourist arrivals and a vibrant small business sector. As the world has, we have experienced much in our fight against the COVID-19 pandemic, but our spirit is a resilient one. For West Grand Bahama and Bimini, it is and will always be about your future. I am proud to be a candidate and a member of this great free national movement under the leadership of Dr. Hubert Minnis. West Grand Bahama and Bimini, vote FNM. It's about your future.
Ring the bell! FNM!
I'm voting for in Western and Bimini. I tell them decision is lit to
see. We're ready!
Pakisha Parker Edgecombe is my MP.
Surrender!
The beautiful people of Western. Everyone in 8 Mile Rock Settlement.
I asked.
We voted Parker
Edgecombe. I asked one question. And I said to the voters going to the polls, has the government of the Bahamas been effective in its management? And will this government remain with the Free National Movement? And you know what I am hearing? Yes, we are. Listen, the time is drawing nigh. And I want each and every one of you to know that my colleagues here in Grand Bahama and my colleagues throughout the Commonwealth of the Bahamas have given all that we can amidst a pandemic as well as a hurricane to ensure that each and every one of you and your children have a better future. Were there challenges? Yes, there were. But can we overcome it? Yes, we will. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to know today that we are about the future. The children are important to us, you are important to us, and we will vote FNM! We knew what that storm did to our country. Category 5, never ever experienced in the region. 2 years later, they say we've done nothing. They tell the stories about what they believe we shoulda, coulda, woulda have done already. But the truth is we are building back better and we are going to be stronger and there is nothing that they can do about it. FNMs, they will come and they will huff and they will puff. But when they do, I want you to tell them something and make sure they hear you loud. We are still rocking with Doc.
I came to win, to fight, to conquer, to thrive. I came to.
I am now the Minister of State for the Disaster Reconstruction. And I tell you, the ministry that I have been fortunate enough to lead for the last 5 months after my colleague, the Honorable Iram Lewis, did what he could to make sure that as we move forward, we are building back more resilient. We have partnered with people from all around the world to ensure that our country becomes stronger. We have demonstrated that in the wake and the aftermath of a hurricane, that we will come together and we will stay together. We will build back better. We are doing tremendous work, and don't let them make you believe that we're not doing anything. We have helped thousands of homeowners. We are building back better in Abaco, from the utilities to infrastructure, from the utilities to the schools, to the clinics. We are doing what we're supposed to do as a government. And if you were to go and find that information, and don't let them clog your minds up with the rubbish that they bring every time, you would know that we will win. And like I said, there is nothing that can stop us, not even the PLP.
I came to win, to fight, to conquer, to thrive. I came to win.
West Grand Bahama and Bimini, when they come at one, they come at all. They believe that by trying to hit me off my feet, that I would have stumbled and fall. But little do they know that when they mess with one, they mess with many. We are going to the polls and we are going to vote them out. Not because of the fact that we just want to go to the polls and vote them out, but because we have a record to demonstrate that we have worked for the last 4.5 years and that we will continue working to empower each and every one of our constituents. We have trained, we have educated, we have assisted, we have fed, we have done what we had to do in all of the circumstances that we were faced with. And we are not going to stop because we're going after empowerment for each and every one of you. Empowerment for all. We are here to make a difference, and we will. FNMs, this is a serious time in our country. We cannot stay inside and believe that by doing so, we will be able to effectively move forward. They are counting for you to stay inside. They are counting to make sure that you are so frustrated that you don't come out and vote. They say FNMs aren't happy and they stay at home. But let me tell you something. This time around, every single one of you go to those polls and shock them, shock them, shock them. Tonight, we are all about the future. I am happy to represent West Grand Bahama and Bimini. And I can tell you one thing. We are going to rise, West Grand Bahama and Bimini. You will be hearing more about it as we move forward. But we're coming back, and we're going to reclaim the capital, which is West End, and the gateway, which is Bimini, will continue to succeed. I say to each and every one of you, stay prayed up, come out and vote, and make sure that the PLP has 0-0-0. I love you all, and we'll be talking. God bless you all, and let's go FNMs. FNMs!
Filled with catastrophe, but she knows she can fly away. Oh, she got both feet on the ground, and she's burning it down. Oh, she got her head in the clouds, and she's not backing down. This girl is on fire. This girl is on fire.
Grand Bahama, how you feeling? Listen, I won't hear more noise than that because I come far, far. This is Novi, your girl. Blow them horns, flick them lights. somebody. Hey, hey.
It's all about you and me together in our country. Together we will unite for each other, do what's right. Together as one, we will continue to grow and build.
Somebody scream!
It's about your future, economy, culture, working together. It's about our future, becoming back greater, stronger than ever. It's about your future.
All right, you gotta do a little rake and scrape now. Here we go. Hey, hey. Anybody from West End?
Committed to excellence, democratic governance.
Everybody
take a stand for this Bahama land. Ingenuity, Bohemian
art. All right.
With cultural enterprise.
Entrepreneurs, we will rise. It's about your future, economy, culture, working together. It's about your future, becoming back greater, better than ever. It's about our future.
Let me see the flags in there. Here we go. Put your flag in the air. Put your flag in the air. Here we go.
It's about your children, their education, the generation. Here we go. It's about your future. Becoming back greater. It's about our future. It's about your future, economy, culture, working together. It's about our future, becoming back greater, stronger than ever. It's about our future.
Hey! Anybody from East End? West End? Freeport? Grand Bahama? Make some noise!
It's about our future. It's about our future.
Hey, all of Grand Bahama, let me see you blow them horns. Blow your horns. Flick your lights. Wave your flag. Put your foot in the air. I don't care what you do tonight. Let them know it's all about your future. Run the track, money. Run the track. Huh, huh. If you're a proud Bahamian, let me see you wave your hands like this. Come on. Here we go.
We coming back to continue what we started. And to continue what we have begun. The free national movement. All FNM together as one. With a creative celebration. Culture and heritage expansion. Faith and resilience.
Guess what? I am a proud Bohemian.
With your torch in the air.
Put your flag. Raise your flag. Raise your flag. Hey, 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 hey.
Oh, yeah, we coming back again. With the pride in my heart. Yeah, we coming back.
Oh, yeah.
Coming back.
Yes, we coming back. Put your torch in.
expansion.
Culture and heritage expansion.
Faith, love, and unity.
Here we go.
With the tourism industry.
We coming back.
Oh, yeah, we coming back.
Yeah, we coming back.
Junkanoo.
Your belly, yeah,
anybody want Junkanoo to come back?
Yeah,
you gotta get vaccinated,
back,
everybody.
Yeah.
Future. Somebody say, yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes, we coming back. Yes, we coming back. Yes, we coming back. Yes, coming back.
FNMs, I need you to remember the proper COVID protocols. Stay within your groups, keep your mask on, and keep safe. Social distance. FNMs, are you all ready to take all five in Grand Bahama? Come on now, make some noise. Next to the stage, we have the tallest MP there. The tallest candidate, sorry. Who will be the next MP for the great constituency of East Grand Bahama? Next to the stage, you will hear Kwesi Thompson!
FNM, 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 FNM.
Hello, Bahamas. My name is Kwesi Thompson. I am from the wonderful island of Grand Bahama. I am a father, a husband, and a proud Bahamian, asking for your support to represent the great constituency of East Grand Bahama. It would be my goal, once I am elected, to continue our efforts to rebuild East Grand Bahama, continue to revitalize the economy of Grand Bahama, and to have special focus on our young people, providing opportunities through the use of technology. I am proud to have the support of my family, my wife Tammy, my daughter Jaden, who is a first-time voter in East Grand Bahama, and all of my constituents. I am proud to be a candidate and a member of the Free National Movement Party under the leadership of Dr. Hubert Minnis. East Grand Bahama, vote FNM. It's about your future.
FNM, 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 FNM.
It's LC the beat guy.
East Grand Bahama, East Grand Bahama. East Grand Bahama, we voting crazy. We voting crazy. We voting crazy. We voting crazy.
FNMs!
East Grand Bahama.
Oh, FNMs!
We voting crazy.
You all look good tonight!
He's been working, and he's still working.
FNMs! If you believe that we take in not one, not two, not three, not four, we take in all five in Grand Bahama, you better make some noise in this place tonight.
FNM, FNM, FNM,
FNMs, if you red and you never scared, you better make some noise tonight. I'm going to take a moment. I'm going to take a moment to recognize our leader, our prime minister, who has arrived on the property tonight. He has been tested
and he has been tried. Make some noise, FNMs, for the best leader
it's about
that we have seen. Our doctor, Dr. Hubert Alexander Menes.
It's about our future.
FNMs, 20 years ago, you elected a young lawyer as torchbearer president right here in Grand Bahama. It has been my honor to serve 5 years as a member of parliament and as a deputy speaker. 9 years as a senator, and it has been my privilege to now serve as your Minister of State for Grand Bahama and Finance. And ladies and gentlemen, tonight, it is my honor you know, that's what you got to do when you're 5 feet, something, something, something. It is my honor to be nominated as a candidate for the East Grand Bahama constituency. And listen, by the grace of God, to be the next member of parliament for East Grand Bahama.
FNM, FNM, FNM.
I give all praise and thanks to God, who is the head of my life. Listen, I am who I am because of the grace of God. And let me take a moment to say thank you to my beautiful wife, Tammy, who will be voting for her husband on September 16th. But let me also say thank you. Let me also say thank you to my firstborn daughter, Jaden, because she will also, as a first-time voter, will be voting for her daddy. But hold on, hold on. Let me also say thank you to my mother, who also will be voting for her son. And then hold on, hold on, hold on. My three sisters, I gotta say thank you to them because they voting for their brother. Man, we all in East Grand Bahama and we all voting FNM, baby.
FNM, 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 FNM.
My brothers and sisters, this has been some of the most difficult times that we face. And this is one of the most important elections in our history. Never before have the stakes been so high. So FNMs, let us keep our focus on our common goal. All of our energies and forces must now come together. We must be in the fight because this is a fight for our nation. Stronger, together, and together we can. The last 4 years has not been easy. But you know something? We don't complain. The last 4 years in Grand Bahama has been some of the most challenging we've ever seen. But this government, my leader, our leader, Dr. Menes, he has been tested like no other. Listen, you know there's nothing like when you have been tested. There is nothing like when you've been gone through the fire. You can see who you really are when you have gone through the fire. And like people say, tough times never last. But tough people like Dr. Minnis will last. Listen, tell Brave Davis and the new so-called PLP that you gotta be tested before you could be trusted. In spite of Dorian and in the midst of COVID, we have saved the jobs and taken back the Grand Lucayan. We found a good partner who has a real plan for tourism. Listen, we own it, and it is now in the hands of the people of Grand Bahama. In spite of it all, we are still standing. For years, we have been dictated to on that same airport right down the street. Today, the Grand Bahama Airport belongs to the people of Grand Bahama. And the FNM will see that a new airport will be built right here, the airport we in Grand Bahama deserve. We own it, and it is now in the hands of the people. Listen, in spite of it all, we are still standing. Under this government, home porting has been brought to Grand Bahama for the first time in our history, bringing jobs and economic activity. In spite of Dorian and in the midst of COVID, we have provided jobs for Grand Bahama. Remember jobs in the 52-week program, jobs in rebuilding our schools, jobs in the largest renovation ever at our courthouse, jobs at renovating the post office, jobs at rebuilding our hospital, and jobs paving our roads in Hudson Estate, West End, and all throughout East Grand Bahama. That was done by the FNM.
FNM, 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 FNM.
In spite of Dorian and in the midst of COVID, we signed the Carnival deal. Remember that? We signed the West Atlantic Medical School deal where we have Bahamians employed today. We are working on the Grand Bahama Shipyard, where there is a $300 million expansion. Doctors Hospital in their new hospital, Discovery Bay in their new hotel project, and yes, Solomon's Food Store coming back downtown. In spite of it all, we are still standing here in Grand Bahama. FNM's The Bahamian economy is beginning to turn. The Bahamas is coming back. We are exceeding our expectations. And notwithstanding the worst downturn because of COVID, under the leadership of our doc, we have still managed to have the largest amount of investment of all small island states. That was under the FNM.
I'm still standing, yeah. So push it up, push it up, push it up. You're still standing, you're still standing. Oh, push it up.
FNMs, this election is about your future. This election is about the future of our children. This election is about the future of Grand Bahama. It is about the future of our Bahamas. Ladies and gentlemen, over the next 5 years, I will fight night and day for your future. Let's keep Grand Bahama moving forward. Let's keep Grand Bahama red. And let's keep all five seats FNM. Ladies and gentlemen, God bless you and good night.
FNM, 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 FNM.
It's LC the beat guy.
East Grand Bahama, East Grand Bahama, East Grand Bahama. We voting crazy.
I'll be taking we all five, Grand crazy. Bahama.
We voting
if
crazy.
If we taking five, we blow your horns, make some noise.
East Grand Bahama.
Alright, 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 FNM.
We voting crazy.
I need you guys to remember the protocols. Remember the protocols. Stay to your cars. Social distance. And next on stage, it's the great Iron Lewis.
Hello, Bahamas. My name is Kwesi Thompson. I am from the...
My name is Iron Lewis. I grew up in a very small community on the north side of Grand Bahama called Waterkey. So growing up in a small community was extremely enriching. It was very powerful. I learned how to be a team player. I learned about community. I learned about being your brother's keeper. I learned a lot about love and care. I am Iron Lewis, armor bearer for the Free National Movement, that great constituency of Central Grand Bahama.
That his wife is going to vote for him. His daughters will vote for him. Well, I live in East Grand Bahama, and let me tell you, I will also be voting for you. Grand Bahama, what I see today, I'm so proud of you. You are making history. This is the very first drive-through rally, and we are doing it in grand style in Grand Bahama. Well organized, you're well behaved, and I just want to remind you, we are in the pandemic. We want you to observe the protocols, remain as well behaved as you are. Some of us had COVID, some of us knew someone who had COVID, someone knew someone who died from COVID. So by all means, continue to observe the protocols, keep yourself safe and your family safe. We cannot stress that enough. I would like to stand on established protocol, but I'd also like to recognize the presence of Prime Minister, party leader, as well as our Deputy Prime Minister, the member for Carmichael. Come on, give him a hand. And while I stand on the established protocol, let me ask you a question. Who are you voting for? I can't hear you. I think we want to do that one more time. Who are you voting for? Yes, I have to be brief because we have a curfew to observe. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time. Who are you voting for? Oh, that's a sweet sound. I thought they said we're mad. The people mad with us. But from what I see, we are red and ready. As a young man, as the video said, from Water Key, and entering into frontline politics, for the first time in 2017, I realized that I, along with you, had come a long way. From the small community of Water Key to representing my country at the Olympics, from victories to defeat, I had all kinds of experiences, and they had prepared me for this moment. I had certain goals for Central Grand Bahama, my constituency, and even though we did not achieve some of those things, I am proud of the things that we did achieve. Let me list some of them. We launched backyard farming, and to date, not only have we distributed over 200 backyard kits for residents to start their own farm, but we also developed the community garden and the Central Grand Bahama nursery at Behemoth Services. You know, we didn't stop there. Last summer, with the assistance of countless volunteers, we cleared and have developed the area of the Royal Oasis opposite the International Bazaar, now known as the Grand Bahama Community Park, where I am proud to say that we have had not one, not two, but three successful farmers market. The first farmers market, we had 38 vendors. The second farmers market, we had 47. And just last week, at our farmers market, we had 60 vendors. That showed growth. That shows progress.
Are you serious?
Dead serious. Other successes included the renovation of the YMTA in Hunters, works down at the Boiling Hole in Hebron Town, renovation of the Lighthouse Point in Pinders Point, where we have not the lighting of the Christmas tree, but lighting of the lighthouse. You know, they say, in our 4.5 years of governance, that the Free National Movement has done nothing. Nothing, they said. It is a regular chant. In fact, about a week ago, now listen to this. I saw a commercial yesterday, a PLP commercial, where a young man was saying, we see y'all every 5 years. You take us to the bar, you buy us liquor, and you think we're alcoholics. But while he's saying that, he had a Bud Light in his hand. What an oxymoronic statement. Now, last week, they were in front of the multi-million dollars upgrade to the Rand Memorial Hospital. And they say, we ain't doing nothing, but you're doing your press conference right in front of the building that we're working on. How could you say that? But that is just the nature of the PLP. Now, you know, they're only grasping for straws. Let us not forget the restoration of the High Rock and McLeanstown Clinic. Shall we also remind them of the millions of dollars spent to complete, right down the road, the fishing hole causeway, the very road that separates West Grand Bahama from the city of Freeport? Whenever there's flood tide, we have an issue. But through our government, the weaknesses that was exposed during Dorian, we designed it and we built it back better. And guess what? They're mad. They're mad because we do it. But who mad? Let them stay mad.
They never do nothing for me. From last election gone, all the people I'm still in mourn. I died in the PLP.
And you know, what about the fabulous, and perhaps the most outstanding infrastructural development in this country, the Smith's Point Seawall? Oh, that's right, the Smith's Point Seawall. But you know, we didn't do anything. They said that because we made it better than they intended it for it to be. So do you think we should talk about the speedy improvement made to the Grand Bahama Sporting Complex and the YMCA within weeks of my appointment as Minister of Youth, Sports, and Culture? The seats that were sitting in Nassau, in disrepair, unused, while our residents were sitting on the hot concrete, on the cold concrete, on the wet concrete, on the hard concrete during sporting events, that is a thing of the past. Or the new timing system and the high-tech starting blocks that we put at the YMCA pool to help our swimmers. Because as you know, Grand Bahama produced some of the best swimmers in the country. And if you don't believe me, ask Joanna Evans. Ask Marvin Johnson, two of our great outstanding swimmers. You know, but I don't think we should mention these points, because the fact that we are mentioning these points and we are doing things, it means that the PLP are misleading their supporters. But we will continue to list them and remind them that we are doing things and keep this island FNM.
We still rocking with Doc.
You know, we shouldn't talk about all that, because even though we went through Hurricane Dorian, like was mentioned by member for East, and still going through the pandemic for the past year and a half, I don't know when it will end. This government, your FNM government, has accomplished much. And you'd better believe this, when you re-elect us, you will see that the best is yet to come. Be ready, be ready, vote FNM.
Hey, y'all, 1, 2, 3, get up, we got victory. No weapon they throw at me, you know it won't prosper now.
Grand Bahama, to Grand Bahama, this is only the beginning. With our fearless leader at the helm, Dr. Hubert Minnis, the doc that we are working with. Imagine what we could have achieved if all of our cylinders were burning instead of us going half speed, full speed, and stop. But still, through it all, under our leadership, the Bahamas has moved and is still moving. Just look around. When we have been through the ringer, and you still see signs of growth, development, and progress. When you head to the polls in a few weeks, September 16th, remember, every vote counts. Do not stay at home figuring that we have this one in the bag. They don't need my one vote. Every vote from east to west, all the way to Bibney, please come out. Encourage your family members, encourage your friends, encourage your colleagues. Remind them to come out and vote FNM. Remember, September 16 is about your future. Be red, be red, be ready. Vote FNM.
Gentlemen, brothers and sisters, stay by your cars. Stay in your cars. We're going to show them how we do it right with treating our people and taking care of them during this COVID time. So you're going to work with us tonight. Stay in, stay on, stay near. No walking around, social distances, because we are the government all about your future. And coming up next, to make sure we see the best Grand Bahama have to have after collections of stars, let us bring on KB 8 Mile Rock.
Oh no!
What are they talking about?
What are they talking about?
What are they talking about?
What are they talking about? The FNM is like no way. A better future, a better day. Steady leadership that's led the way. And the FNM's been like no way. Listen, when times were rough, they held it down. They brought relief to every town. And ooh, the FNM's
been lighting the way. Where the Dorian or the Cobra Scourge, they felt our pain, held every word. Listen! Ooh, the FNM's been lighting the way.
Check it out!
Hey, watch! For all the times I've led the way, for all the time you've got to say, for tomorrow and today, yeah.
Listen here.
Leadership is what leaders bring. Can't wait to vote on September 16th. FNM's, let me hear you sing.
Hey!
There were tough times we had to take, but he came the night.
Listen!
He kept us safe. And ooh, the FNM's been lighting the way. Helping Bahamas heal, help Bahamas.
What to say? FNM's, how you feeling? Listen here, come on.
Ooh, the FNM's been lighting the way.
What do you say? Watch it, watch, watch, come on.
For all the times he's kept the same, for all the times he's led the way, for tomorrow and today, hey,
listen here.
True leadership is what leaders bring. Can't wait to vote.
Hey, I want to hear that bell ring.
FNM, let me hear you sing.
Hey, watch it.
For all the times we held it down,
listen, we got relief
into every town. And ooh, the FNM's been lighting the way.
All the time, FNMs, what y'all got to say? Say, hey! Listen here, I want y'all to sing with me. Check it, check it, check it, check it. Watch this. Come on.
For all the time he's kept the same, for all the time he led the way, for tomorrow and today. September 16th. FNM's, let me hear you sing.
Hey, hey, listen here, come on.
For all the times they were saying, for all the times you led the way. FNM's, let me hear you say,
hey,
hey. True leadership is what leaders bring. Can't wait to vote on September 16th.
Let me hear you scream! Hey, 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 come on! FNMs!
We are the FNMs! Honk those horns! Ladies and gentlemen,
LP Bar,
the people's bye, man, bye. The man who has taught us how to bye, grow, how to feed, bye, how to treat ourselves well. Marco City in the house. Bye, bye. Let us say it for Michael Pintard.
Hi, my name is Michael Pintard. I'm the Member of Parliament for Marco City. This is a distinct pleasure and an honor to have this opportunity to not only be the voice, but also to be a partner with the residents of Marco City. We have run the most extensive hurricane relief support program in Grand Bahama. We run an extensive feeding program that contributes to residents who from time to time may face challenges. We've worked with the broader Grand Bahama community and the members of Parliament as we cleaned up Grand Bahama. We've worked with our children on a number of educational initiatives, not just back to school, but assisting throughout the school year with a variety of initiatives. We are excited to work with our seniors, having hosted them every year. I'm proud to be a part of a political organization with a leader and deputy leader who understands the challenges that we face and who are committed to working on helping to solve them, not just now, but into the future.
We're coming back again.
FNMs.
He said, no matter what you're going through, I know it's rougher than it's ever been for you. My God said he wants you to
It's good to be here tonight. Grand Bahamians, you continue to prove that no matter what you go through, you are able to stand. The truth is, you have been going through a difficult time for more than 15 years, and you've stayed in the fight. A number of persons have left, and we're not angry with them. Everyone deserves to fight for the best opportunity for their families. But many of you have soldiered through, regardless of your personal frustrations and difficulties. We've lost a number of our citizens, particularly over the last 2 years. Dorian took some folks that we loved, some possessions that we had built for decades. And COVID came and we lost loved ones. But God is so merciful that in the midst of the challenges that we have had, we continue to stand in Grand Bahama. There are some who are attempting to tell you that all the troubles that you have had, all the troubles you are experiencing, that you ought to lay it at the feet of this government. Lie them a tell. But you know, that there are some difficulties that have existed under both administrations. The question for us tonight is, who do we believe that in the worst of times got our back? I believe tonight, and I share with you, that notwithstanding that we didn't get everything right, that sometimes we didn't move at the pace that you desired, we care about what happens to you going into the future and the future of your children. And that is why tonight we're asking you, despite the challenges that we have, despite some shortfalls we have experienced, let's do it again together. Grand Bahama, the future of this country is secure in the hands of the Free National Movement. And we make a commitment to you that we will govern with humility. We work for you. You are our bosses. We make a commitment to you that we believe that we can have an agriculture revolution in this country, that the $1 billion of food that we're importing is unacceptable, and we have to change the way we function. Our future cannot depend on someone from a distant land feeding us. That time is over.
It's about our future.
We decided we will protect the marine resources of this country, the natural resources for future generations. The truth is, we are as talented as anyone else, anywhere else in the world. And that's why we invested in small business development and why more funds will be placed in your hands. In your hands, not our hands. You do a better job spending the money than the government of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. Our future is secure when we decide in Grand Bahama that we are going to build a film and entertainment industry that can employ thousands of young people internationally. The creative arts is generating employment in the United States, in Canada, in Europe. And the Bahamas understands clearly that if we are going to have a secure future, we need to electrify the creativity of our people, unleash it, and fund it. And that is our intention going into the future. No longer can we simply rely on tourism and financial services. You have demonstrated on this island with this small population that in non-traditional ways you are surviving despite the challenges that you face. We wish to continue to partner with you. I'm asking you to pool resources. The truth is, we are better every time we work together than work against each other. And that is precisely why the new politics in the Bahamas is not the tribalism that exists, but us deciding we are prepared to even work across party lines, because we need the collective genius of Bahamians to succeed as a people. And so, Grand Bahamians, I'm asking you, in the midst of your challenges and frustrations, I need you to talk to your neighbors. and tell them that the Free National Movement has their back. We will work with you and for you. Tell them that we need them to come out to the polls and vote. It's safe to vote, and we are the safer bet to vote for. Ask yourself the question. Look at the track record of those that wish to lead and ask yourself that if someone has not performed well in their own constituency, if they have not demonstrated the ability to create conditions necessary for the development of their people, and I'm not saying, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying they didn't do some good things, they didn't touch some people with a slow 5 or faded 10 or a wrinkled 20, maybe it was even 100 or 50, I'm not saying that. But have they created the conditions necessary that people who are industrious, people who are prepared to work hard and smart can succeed? And the answer is no.
It's about our future.
Because if you can't do it on a local level, how in God's name you could do it on a national level? And so tonight as I take my seat, I want you to know we care about you. We understand that, yes, we have an amazing feeding program, but you want to feed yourself. That's why we're going to work with you. But nevertheless, in the midst of the challenge, we provided the social safety net to ensure that we diminish the suffering. And as you listen to the leadership, we seek to speak life over the nation and not try to convince you that every miserable situation is the fault of somebody else. And so tonight when you leave here, we need you to go back in every constituency and talk to those relatives who are thinking about staying home. We need them to come out. Your future depends on it. Talk to the PLPs, not as enemies. They are our brothers and sisters, and encourage them. They know what they're facing. That's why they're not motivated. But encourage them to give this political organization who cares about your future an opportunity to continue what we started. The final thing I'd say is this. People said, listen, there's no explanation for why you couldn't do more. Let me offer only one. A small country like the Bahamas had a hit with Dorian of over $3 billion, with a B, billion dollars. Under COVID, a similar figure. A small country like ours taking more than a $6.5 billion hit makes a difference in your prospects to do the things you wish to do for your people. Our agenda is not yet complete, but with your help and by the grace of God, we can complete it. And so I'm asking you tonight to do the work, not on the back of the trucks, but do it door to door. Do it on the telephone. Do it in your workplace. Tell them that the Free National Movement remains the best option. The best option isn't somebody who's telling you, listen, you could stay home, drink a stitchy, smoke a blunt, and get $100,000. Lie, dem a tell. The best option isn't making the point that every problem you have ever had is the responsibility of the Free National Movement. The best option is that tough medicine that's telling you if we stand together, if we work together, if we pray together, we could change this country for the better. God bless all of you.
He said, I'm hurting now, and I'm seeing your tears. My God said he wants you to know I'm still here.
He said, no matter what you're working together.
I know
all
it's
right, we love each other. Don't forget, in your cars, on your cars, beside your cars, COVID protocol. Please, don't be walking up and down if you don't have to. Let's stay safe. Together, we can. Ladies and gentlemen, we are honored all the way from Nassau to have our Deputy Prime Minister, the Honorable Desmond Bannister, Minister of Works, to address us tonight.
Good night, Grand Bahama. Good night, Grand Bahama. It is wonderful to be here with you tonight. Grand Bahama, thank you for being safe. Thank you for being socially distanced tonight. You know, ladies and gentlemen, Grand Bahama is a very special place for the Free National Movement. And that's why we are launching our national campaign here tonight. And we are doing it safely. We are in the middle of a worldwide pandemic. Every country on the face of this earth is faced with COVID. But tonight and yesterday in Grand Bahama, your numbers are down. Thank you for leading the way, Grand Bahama. Thanks to our Prime Minister, we now have all the vaccines. We have the Pfizer, we have the AstraZeneca, we have the Johnson & Johnson. You have a choice, so please get vaccinated. I also want to congratulate Grand Bahama on your resilience. You know, no matter how bad the storm may have been, the people of Grand Bahama always rise again. I remember the devastation of Francis and Jane in September 2004. But Grand Bahama defied the cynics, and you built back even stronger. And you're doing the same after Dorian. I want to tell you that the resilience of Grand Bahama is an inspiration to the Bahamian people. And I know that you will never, ever surrender. The Free National Movement believes in Grand Bahama. And that is why we are the only party that's backed up our promises with action in Grand Bahama. You can see, you can touch, and you can feel what we've done here. I'll start with Smith's Point. The PLP wasted millions of dollars trying to build a seawall in Smith's Point, and they still couldn't get it right. They were incompetent. If you'd left it up to them, Smith's Point would have been devastated by Dorian. And Brave Davis wants to be Prime Minister, and he couldn't build a seawall. The FNM had to build that fantastic seawall to protect Smith's Point. And right now, Kwesi Thompson is busy working in the community. Thank you, Kwesi. East Grand Bahama loves you. Thank you, Kwesi, for inspiring us so that during the second minister's administration, we will build a sparkling, spanking, brand new school for the people of East Grand Bahama. A new seawall for High Rock. And we are going to be investing millions in climate resilient infrastructure in the East. Grand Bahama, count on the FNM and count on Kwesi. I'll tell you something else at the PLP. They couldn't even build a decent bridge. We all know the problems with the Fishing Hole Road. You know, Brave wants to be Prime Minister and he couldn't build a bridge. Iram Lewis had to come to the rescue as a parliamentary secretary in the Ministry of Works. And now, thanks to Iram, we have a wonderful bridge in central Grand Bahama. We have the eco parks at the Boiling Hole in Hepburn Town, Lighthouse Point and Pindus Point, Community Park at the Princess, the Central Grand Bahama Nursery, the Monthly Farmers Market, and the First Smart Park in Hunters. Central Grand Bahama, Iram is a worker, and you are benefiting from his dedication. We want to see Iram back in Parliament. Grand Bahama, Michael Pintard is one of the most committed men that I have ever met. Aside from his complete focus on the people of Marco City, he is ensuring that the Harold and Gregory building is restored properly. He's also currently building three magnificent parks, 1.6 acres in Mansfield Park, 8 acres in Poinciana Gardens, with the basketball court completed, the children's basketball playground almost be delivered, and 1.6 acres in Gambier Loop, and the technology hub for our children. Marco City, Michael gets the job done. Pakika Sherpaka Edgecombe loves the West and Bimini. You can tell by her steady focus on assisting hundreds of homeowners through the DRA. There's $6 million that's being invested in repairs to the Bimini Airport. The boat ramps, the fish cleaning stations that she is constructing in West Grand Bahama, in excess of $1 million invested in roadworks in West Grand Bahama, in Boodle Bay, and in parts of 8 Mile Rock, and our focus on the soon-to-be-completed school in Holmes Rock and the administrative complex in High Rock. Grand Bahama, we love Pakisha. Now, Grand Bahama, all of the people that I mentioned are ministers. 80% of the MPs in Grand Bahama are ministers. You will not find that anywhere else. Not a single one of them grabbed their toys and went home when they were not appointed a minister. Pine Ridge, you need an MP. And you need an MP who can be a minister in the second minister's administration. So even when the former MP sucked his teeth and turned his back on the party, the FNM is still looking after Pine Ridge. We have invested millions in creating jobs when we renovated the courts so that they can live up to the distinguished name of Garnet Lavarity. And more millions creating jobs and ensuring that you will soon have the best post office in the country. Pine Ridge and Grand Bahama, you know Wellborn Boodle. You know his decades of service in the Royal Bahamas Police Force. You know his service at road traffic. He is a man you can trust. Pine Ridge, Boots is on the ground, and we need Boodle. Grand Bahama, you currently have $7 million worth of road work going on, and there's more to come. That's never happened before under any other party. Stick with the FNM. Now, I want you to understand one thing as I leave here tonight. We are not greedy, but we want the 5 seats.
Walk and live.
We want every seat in Grand Bahama. We work for it. We deserve it. And Grand Bahama, you just keep in rocking with Doc. Good night, ladies and gentlemen.
Pine Ridge, Wellborn Boodle. on the ground.
My name is Wellborn Bootle. I am the son of Abaco and a proud descendant of Grand Bahama, a place where I have lived and raised my children. I am a retired law enforcement officer and a proud Bahamian, asking for your support to represent the great constituency of Pine Ridge. It has always been my dream to serve my country in a higher capacity. It will be my goal when I am elected to directly address the cares and concerns I heard while talking to the residents of Pine Ridge. Issues such as youth empowerment, elderly care, homelessness, neighborhood crime watch, and many more. I am proud to have the support of my wife, Melrose, children, and the community of Pine Ridge. I am proud to be a candidate and a member of this great Free National Movement Party under the leadership of Dr. Hubert Minnis. Vote FNM. It's about your future.
When I say pine, you say rich. Pine, rich. Pine, rich. Pine, rich.
Ah, let's go. FNMs? FNMs? Are you ready, FNMs? Are you ready to vote, FNMs? Good evening to you. In the words of the great Mahatma Gandhi, our ultimate future depends on what we do in the present. What we do now, in this defining moment, will determine the future of our country. Most Honorable Prime Minister, Deputy Prime Minister, Cabinet Ministers, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, family and friends, the Great Pine Ridge Constituency Association, and a hardworking team of boots on the ground. A pleasant good evening to you. Let me begin by thanking the Almighty God for giving me this opportunity to serve the people of Pine Ridge. My dear wife, Melrose, children, siblings, family members, friends, and the great Boots on the Ground team for your faithful support. Pine Ridge, it is a pleasure and an honor for me to stand before you this evening and to pledge that, God's willing, I will be your next member of parliament. One with a vision, a new voice, and a history of service to this country. Pine Ridge, allow me the opportunity to reintroduce myself to you and to present my credential of lifelong service to this nation and the protection of the future of this country. Many of you may not know me. However, I served this community as a law enforcement officer for over 20 years. My specialty is forensics, crime scene investigation, and fingerprint technology. This is where I learned to respect the scientific process. I understand the decisions that the most honorable prime minister made. After all, he's a brilliant doctor, one who cares. My journey in life started in Bootle Town, Abaco, where the story of Grand Bahama was told to me by my grandparents, Prince Albert Bootle of West End and Eliza Ballou Bootle of Old Freetown and Water Key. My parents and grandparents taught me the value of service. I began my service to the Bahamian people as a member of the Royal Bahamas Police Force in 1973, the year of independence. I was privileged, proud, and blessed to be a part of the parade that ushered in the birth of our Bahamian nation. I served this country as a law enforcement officer from Inagua in the south to Grand Bahama in the north. I have seen Grand Bahama at its highest peak of glory and lowest valley of despair. One of the saddest moments in my life in Grand Bahama was the mystery of the five missing boys in 2003. I served as the head of the Forensic Crime Scene Unit investigating this tragedy. This abuse of the future generation of children must never be allowed to happen again in Grand Bahama or in our country. These boys were only 11, 12, 13, and 14. They had a bright future that never materialized. Ladies and gentlemen, these are serious times that require serious leadership. This election is really about the future generation of Bahamians. This is more than a cliche. This is reality. I had the opportunity to lead several departments on Grand Bahama as a police officer. The Criminal Records Department, the Eastern Division, Mobile Division, Traffic Division, and the Corruption Unit. I understand the sacrifices of police officers. Officers, we cannot thank you enough for all you have done. The FNM has always been there for you and will continue to be. Yes, I know what it's like to leave your family and look danger in its face day after day, to be left on remote islands not knowing if you will return alive. You do it for love of country, even when you are underappreciated. Thanks again, officers, for your work in this country. I am here now to serve the people of Pine Ridge. I have committed my service to you as a man of faith and a faithful servant of the people. I know Grand Bahama. Grand Bahama is near to my heart. Serving you has been a privilege. As a God-fearing man of faith with years of experience, I am built and prepared for this moment. This is not about ambition. This is about service. Pine Ridge, I am asking for your support and the opportunity to lead you through these difficult times that we face together. This is our defining moment to make a real difference in Pine Ridge and our nation. In the words of the late Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., this is no time for apathy or complacency. Now is the time for vigorous and positive action. End of quote. Pine Ridge, you and I will address homelessness in the community. A recreational center for the senior, entrepreneurial empowerment, the introduction of a 16-member Poland Division Council that will address all concerns in the Pine Ridge constituency. Each Poland Division will have one member, inclusive of youths. You will hear more about this at a later date. The action you take in this election will determine the kind of future we will have in our country. Let's not put our country back in the hands of uncertainty. We are living in challenging times in both our country and globally. Despite unprecedented catastrophic events, namely the deadly storm to hit the Bahamas, Hurricane Dorian, and COVID-19, the global pandemic that shifted the world, the Minister administration has led us through with distinction. It takes great tenacity to lead through tough times. If he led us through these tough times, what do you think he would do in good times? Oh, man. Okay. There is a, I must tell you the story. While campaigning, I met a lady, and she told me that she voted PLP all of her life. She is now 79, almost 80. She said, son, I have nothing to lose. But let me tell you that the work that the prime minister is doing, I am voting FNM. So, ladies and gentlemen, I stand firm and commit to serving the people of Pine Ridge through the good times and the bad times. Because the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Okay? We are ready, Grand Bahama. Pine Ridge is ready. Pine Ridge is now ready with boots on the ground, Pine Ridge is ready to march on with Wellborn. And ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. As you go and vote FNM, it is about your future. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce to you tonight the most honorable Prime Minister, Hubert Alexander Minnis.
Tough times.
The Prime Minister of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas.
We are working hard every day to ensure you have a brighter future.
I pledge my allegiance to the flag, united in love and service. Together we stand.
Everybody rock with Doc. 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 Let's walk with Doc. Let's walk with Doc. He's a strong man, someone who will understand. He's a great man with plenty ambition. Everybody rock with Doc. Everybody rock with Doc. Everybody rock with Doc. Everybody rock with Doc. Let's walk with Doc. Let's walk with Doc. He's a strong man, someone who will understand. He's a great man with plenty ambition. He loves his Bahamian people from northeast, west, and south. And everywhere you go, the Bahamian people need to know.
Mr. Prime Minister.
Welcome back.
Everybody walk with Doc. Let's walk with Doc. Let's walk with Doc. He's a strong man, someone who will understand. He's a great man with plenty ambition. He loves his Bahamian people from northeast, west, and south. And everywhere you go, Bahamian people need to know that. Down to Lutro, walk with Doc. Down to Elba, walk with Doc. Down to Long Island, walk with Doc. And Grand Bahama, walk with Doc. And Abaco, walk with Doc. Let Bahamians know, walk with Doc. Don't run the show.
FNMs. Grand Bahama, my Bahamians everywhere. FNMs, if you're going to give me 5 2-thirds horns, Elutra has already promised me twin delivery. Andres, twin delivery. And tell me again, will you give me 5? FNMs, my heart is full tonight. My heart is very full. This past week, I got a phone call from a Bahamian woman approaching her 70th birthday in a few weeks. She told me about 2 dear friends, one younger and one older, that she lost to COVID. We have sadly lost family members, neighbors, friends, and colleagues. And every Bahamian now knows someone who has passed away because of this deadly virus. We continue to mourn them all and to pray for their families. Let us pray also for those who are ill in hospital or at home. During the conversation, the lady who called said that though she was sad, she was also hopeful. She is hopeful because she believes that most Bahamians are now coming forth and taking the vaccine. And I believe that she is right. this week so far, from Monday, just Monday, August 26th, to yesterday, Thursday, Monday, August 23rd, to yesterday, Thursday, August 26th. We vaccinated just over 11,000 people on New Providence, Grand Bahama, and Abaco.
Everybody walk with dog. Let's walk with dog. Let's walk with dog.
These are very good numbers. Abaco was the first island in the country to have the options of all three vaccines. They had the second doses of AstraZeneca, as well as Pfizer and Johnson & Johnson. A healthcare worker in Abaco described vaccine uptake as tremendous. A nurse from Abaco also called me this week to say that the uptake in the Abaco Keys is excellent. Vaccination teams are preparing to go to Eleuthera next week. And I am happy to announce tonight that on Grand Bahama, additional vaccination centers start opening tomorrow. First, in Freeport at Christ the King Hall, and next week, new centers will open in 8 Mile Rock, West End, and Hunters. Both the Pfizer and Johnson & Johnson vaccines will be available. I want you to be sure to check opm.gov.bs/vaccine for the schedules. And visit vax.gov.bs to make your appointment.
Everybody walk with dog. Let's walk with dog.
Let us vaccinate our way out of this pandemic. It is time to end the suffering. It is time to open the economy so Grand Bahamians can get more jobs. It is time to move forward for a better future. And I say, it is time. It is time, and it is time. Grand Bahama, from the very beginning of this terrible pandemic, my mission was always clear in my heart and in my soul. My mission was to save lives, and this is still my mission. Some other people played political games in this pandemic. They pandered and played down the vaccine because they thought vaccines were unpopular. They talked fool and voted against emergency measures like wearing masks and physical distancing. If Brave Davis was leading the country during this pandemic, we would be in much, much worse shape. As a surgeon, you must have steady hands. You can't be flip-flopping all over the place when it comes to making decisions about life and death. Brave Davis proved that he was not ready during this crisis. He proved that he does not have the constitution and the conviction needed to lead when things are tough. This election is about who you trust to get out of this pandemic.
Everybody walk with dog. Let's walk with dog.
The same decisive and determined leadership we showed to get you through this pandemic is the kind of leadership we need to end the emergency phase of this pandemic and to reopen our economy in the months ahead. I am a medical doctor. I have a responsibility as a father and grandfather to do the right thing for my children and my grandchildren. I have a responsibility as your prime minister to do what is right, no matter if it is unpopular at this time. I will not play political games with your life and the lives of your children, grandchildren, and family.
Everybody walk with dog. Let's walk with dog.
Grand Bahama, you have heard me say this over and over again. You will hear me say it again this evening. The only way for us to get out of this emergency phase of the pandemic is if we get vaccinated. We now have three of the best vaccines in the world. The vaccines are being taken around the island to give life-saving protection to our people. I need all of you in Grand Bahama, each and every one of you, and around the country who are not vaccinated to come forward quickly to take your shots. You know, people who got very sick from COVID-19, you know, people who died. There's no more time to wait. My government has launched the largest vaccination campaign in Bahamian history. Dr. Mercilindal Regis has set a target of fully vaccinating 60,000 Bahamians in a 6-week period. And with the rate they're going, they would surpass that. We can end this surge and move to more openness if you come forward and get vaccinated. The Delta variant is causing trouble all over the world. You have seen the pictures on international news. Hospitals are full in rich and poor countries. The countries that are not experiencing overcrowded hospitals are those with high vaccination rates. I have set a goal for the Bahamas to be one of the most vaccinated small island nations in the world. My government has secured well over 500,000 doses of the vaccine. And by getting vaccinated, we can end this wave. by getting vaccinated. We can open up our economy, creating more jobs, new businesses, and expand existing ones.
Everybody walk with dog. Let's walk with dog. Let's walk with dog. He's a strong man, someone who will understand. He's a great man with plenty ambition. He loves his Bahamian people.
Grand Bahama! FNMs! My heart is full tonight for another reason. I love you too. At long last, Grand Bahama is fully coming back. Over the next 5 years, millions of tourists will be coming to Grand Bahama. Early in our next term, we are going to put in place the Home Porting Act, similar to the Hotel Encouragement Act. You have already experienced more visitors from the cruise lines coming to Grand Bahama. We told them that Grand Bahama was a must stop. And there is more to come. There are the big investments for Grand Bahama.
Everybody walk with dog. Let's walk with dog.
As you know, Carnival and Royal Caribbean have agreed to a new combined investment of approximately $350 million in the Grand Bahama shipyard. You might recall that the original investment and other investments to date in the shipyard have totaled approximately $250 million. The new investment will match this and exceed it by $100 million. The proposed infrastructure works will replace the two damaged docks with larger ones. This will mean a notable increase in employment and economic activity on Grand Bahama and for local businesses throughout Freeport and Grand Bahama. The government and the owners of the shipyard will work on a new partnership agreement that benefits the people of Grand Bahama. The expansion of the Grand Bahama shipyard will begin as early. Listen to me. The expansion, that is work for you, will begin as early as October of this year. This is a sign of progress, a sign of hope, and most importantly, a sign of confidence.
Everybody walk with dog. Let's walk with dog. Let's walk with dog. He's a strong man.
Grand Bahama, like the entire Bahamas, is on the way back. This is one of the biggest investments in Grand Bahama in its history. And when we came to office, we made a number of promises to you. Hurricane Dorian and the pandemic resulted in a number of delays. But we have worked tirelessly to renew and to restore Grand Bahama. The government continues to work with Carnival on the permitting process for the Carnival Cruise Port project. We expect to break ground shortly.
Everybody walk with dog. Let's walk with dog.
As promised, the first phase of the Rand Memorial Hospital is finished. This year's budget includes $19 million for the Rand Memorial Hospital four-story expansion. This is in addition to the new pharmacy, the new medical surgical unit, the new maternity ward, the new operating theaters, the new infectious disease ward, the new cafeteria, the new intensive care unit, and the new children's ward that were completed under phase one. We are busy working on the design for phase two. Doctors Hospital has announced its new hospital project here in Grand Bahama. And work on this new private hospital will begin this year and is being done in partnership with Cleveland Clinic. Grand Bahama, in our next term, you are going to get a brand new world-class international airport. A new world-class Freeport International Airport is vital for the renewal of our second most populous island. The government has approved the new Discovery Bay project in Grand Bahama, and the Vela Group intends to develop a mixed-use resort consisting of a 25-key boutique hotel and restaurant, 30 residential estate lots, 12 townhouses, 12 bungalows, a beachfront rental pavilion, a 30-slip marina to be situated in the existing canal system, and a back-of-house facility. At the end of all its phase, this development will exceed $100 million. We are going to help provide affordable land and homes for young professionals, just as we are doing in Nassau. We are going to provide loans and assistance to help develop vacation home rentals, including the residents of East and West Grand Bahama, to have a greater share of the tourism market. FNMs, I have a special message for you tonight. We must be united and remain united during this campaign. Our party has a proud history, leading this country in four different terms. We opened up the airwaves, expanding democracy. We expanded participation of women in the highest offices of the state. We expanded infrastructure across the Family Islands after PLP neglect. We brought integrity back to government time and time again after scandalous PLP administrations. In this election, we must stay united. We must help all our candidates. Tonight, I am asking you to support Iram Lewis for Central Grand Bahama, Kwesi Thompson for East Grand Bahama, Pakisha Parker Edgecombe for West Grand Bahama and Bimini, Michael Pintard for Marco City, and Wilburn Boodle for Pine Ridge. All of them have kept the fire burning in their hearts and their souls. Grand Bahama, we will take five. They have a fire in their soul to help restore our country, because this election is about your future. I know all of you tonight have kept the fire burning. FNMs, we must spread the message to the undecided that the FNM is the best option in this election to govern this Bahamas. On election day, each FNM needs to come to the polls to support our party so we can keep our country out of the hands of brave Davis. Our party has led the Bahamas in this term through its worst times. Hurricane Dorian hit in September 2019 as the worst storm ever in the history of the Bahamas. And 6 months later, we were in the pandemic. But despite the challenges, the FNM has kept fighting for Bahamians. We are fighting for your future. We have worked hard to rebuild what was damaged. We have worked hard to save lives. We have worked hard to save and restore our economy. Our party exists to advance the interests of all Bahamians. We don't need a memorandum of understanding to do good things for working families and Bahamians. During their first 25 years in office, the PLP never introduced the minimum wage. Never. The FNM introduced the minimum wage in the public service and then in the country. The FNM introduced a 40-hour work week. The FNM improved legislation on health in the workplace. It was the FNM that enacted the Industrial Tribunal in law. And this FNM government launched the Small Business Development Center, giving thousands of Bahamians the opportunity to own their own business. Grand Bahama, there is a clear choice for leader between what the FNM is offering and what's on the other side. Throughout this pandemic, I worked hard to keep you safe. We all worked hard to keep you safe. We worked hard to preserve our economy. We provided food to tens of thousands of households. We provided tens of millions of dollars month after month to those who needed unemployment assistance. Listen to me 1 second. We laid nobody off in the public service. We laid nobody off from Bahamas Air or Nassau Flight Services. While the world was laying off people and furloughing people, we determined that if we laid off anybody within our Bahamas, individuals would lose their homes, mortgages. Individuals would lose their rentals. Their water would be cut off. Their lights would be cut off. Their children would not be able to go online to complete schooling. Their cars would be lost. They could not purchase gas for their vehicles. We determined that in this Bahamas, we will take care of our people. But on the other side is Brave Davis. During the first wave, and in the worst crisis in our history, he was arguing and saying, listen to me carefully now, he was arguing during the crisis and emergency, he was arguing and saying, we need to open the bars. He and his party then went to vote against the emergency orders. At every turn in my administration, if my administration proposed it, Brave and his PLP were against it. Braver spent his time in the pandemic trying to figure out what position would be popular. He and I are completely different. We are distinctly different. I wanted to save lives and livelihoods. He wanted to open the bars. You know, I hear Brave is calling himself a new day. You know, I bust out laughing in the Bahamian terms. I bust out laughing when I heard that. I don't know how he could be a new day when he been around the PLP from time immemorial. He is an old PLP. He is a PLP from the dark days of the 80s. His vision for the country is like that of the old PLP of the 80s, and we cannot go back. Bahamians ended that type of governance on August 19, 1992, when they voted for the FNM. PLPs are not happy with Brave as their leader. They know he is not the man for these times. So, I invite all PLPs who are listening to me to join us. You don't have to tell anyone you are voting for FNM. Just go in the booth and mark your X for us. You will mark your X for better governance. You will mark your X for a continued revival of our economy. You will mark your X to get rid of Brave Davis. And after the PLP's disastrous last term, I'm surprised they chose Brave as their leader. Brave is no new day. Brave is yesterday's news. He would take us back to the darkest days in our history. Grand Bahama and my fellow Bahamians, just as we did when you elected the FNM in 2017, we have already begun the work of rebuilding our economy and country. Given all that we have been through, we need to make big, big, comprehensive, and long-term decisions in the post-COVID-19 world. To do this, your government needs a mandate from the people. Tonight, the FNM is asking you, and I am asking you, for a new mandate to help to rebuild our country and economy. I am asking all Bahamians for your votes and for your support. We need to continue to finish the work we started. Grand Bahama, Bahamians everywhere, and FNMs, my heart is full. We are all sad at the loss of so many good people. But I also have hope. I believe in our people. With the vaccines, we are making progress. So I ask you, continue to encourage others to take the vaccine. I watch the discipline here to display tonight with you wearing your mask. I ask all Bahamians to continue to wear their mask. Please stay safe. We will get together again tomorrow in Nassau. Let us continue to pray to the God of new beginnings to deliver us. May the God of mercy bless Grand Bahama and our Commonwealth. I thank you all tonight, but I will return to Grand Bahama with even better news. We have to announce at some time one of the greatest national programs that has ever been thought about that we will introduce here in the Bahamas, and you will hear about that very soon. Thank you very much, and may God bless each and every one of you.